Hi, Carol here, and I made it. Merry Christmas, everybody. I'm so excited I got my card in before Christmas. So my granddaughter wanted me to make her a card. She sent me a picture, and it had just a saying on the front, and it's for her boyfriend. And my granddaughter's name is Caitlin, and it was for her boyfriend, Chris. And I had a half an hour before I went shopping today. I did this in a half an hour. So I grabbed my Tombow markers, the new ones that I had gotten from the stationery store, and I decided to, if I should have really, I'll leave a link if I can find it to, it was just printing the saying on the front, and there was nothing on the inside. I just decided to draw something myself from an image that I found online, and here I'm just quickly getting this out. And I just want to quickly say, I hope everybody has a blessed Christmas with your family and friends. I had a wonderful day today, just a quick going out to get the things that we needed for tomorrow, and I couldn't wait to get back and put this edit up so that I had a card for you that was for Christmas. And it's not difficult. I did the complete card with the envelope in, I think it was 25 minutes. So here we go. I'm going to include the mistakes because I make them all the time. Now, I'm just doing some brush lettering. I'm quickly, just going across the sheet. And yeah, I think this is the W. Put that over there. I think I went through like six cards. I really did, just to get the font that I wanted. And right there, I messed it up because I didn't like the stick going across it. So put it over there. Yes. And I'm getting the voiceover here completed before my hubby gets in. Yeah. So if I was the, and then it's Grinch, I decided to put that in different font. I'm not even sure. I hope this is the good one that I did. I'm not too sure how far I got here. I wouldn't, and I need to put that little apostrophe thingy in there. I wouldn't steal Christmas, and then I'd steal you. Isn't that a cute little saying? And then on the, I did go back and put that little thing on wouldn't, the little apostrophe. So no worries when I finally got it. Before I put it in the envelope, I noticed it. So now I'm going to rub out the line. I had placed a line across here. I love the white erasers. You can't go wrong. And then on the picture that she sent me, it had a little heart on the bottom, just drawn in. But I decided to grab my hearts, dies, and grab a little die and put some little sparkle into the card. So I die cut it, and here I'm just doing my lower lines a little thicker. And you know how it goes when you do the brush lettering. I was just really thrilled to get this done because I was ready to go out the door, and my granddaughter said, "Nan," she emailed me and she said, "Can you make me this card because it's just, printing on the front?" And yeah, I said, "Of course I will." So I took my coat off. Look at that. I have an email. Oh dear. But anyway, I said, "Sure." So I took my coat off and I sat down and I looked at the front, this little saying, that it said, "If I was the Grinch, I wouldn't steal Christmas, I'd steal you." And I thought, oh, I can quickly do this. So I die cut that. I found some glitter paper that I had just a little piece of it. I love that when you just have a little piece. And I'm going to tape it down. And then I'm going to cut one of my cards off that I made a mistake on, turn it over, and you'll never know. Isn't that sweet? So easy peasy. When you look for a link for this saying, I don't know where she got it, but I'll try to leave it up for you on my blog where my granddaughter found this. It's just printing on the front. So you can get away with doing this card if you don't do brush lettering. It's just printing. And then I went on the internet and I found a picture and I just kind of made it my own. I wanted to make a Grinch with a little skirt on. So, yeah, I love to draw. So it didn't take me any time at all to do it. I looked at a picture and then I said, oh yeah, that's not too bad. And I just sketched it out and colored it in with my Prisma pencils. And I just did a two-tone coloring. I don't even think I kept the second one in, but I'll share it with you as we move forward. If I was the Grinch, I wouldn't steal Christmas. I've never seen any movies or anything like that with the Grinch. I mean, I've heard of it, obviously. But yeah, so here I am just trying to think on how I'm going to do it. And I have the picture on my iPad beside me. And I had to just make it smaller, like, you know, as I'm doing it and looking at the picture, because the picture was quite large. And yeah, so anyway, it was easy peasy. Honestly, when you see it, you could do it. Even if you don't draw, you could do this. It's not difficult. Although you can see me rubbing it out, I just had to make sure that I got the proportions right on it. And then once you get that, you're on your way. So I sped this little section up right here because I don't think it's hard to see it done. But I wanted you to see how easy it is to draw. Just have a pencil and a white click eraser. I really like these click erasers. And I just, you know, went over it until I was satisfied. And then I took out my Prisma pencils and I did it in a bright red, a yellow, and a green. And then I went back and just underneath the shaded areas, I did a little bit of a deeper red. And then the white, oh, Prisma white pencil is beautiful. Wait till you see how it just jumps right off the cardstock. You're gonna love it. Yeah, so I got all my Christmas shopping done today. It took me 3 hours and it was wonderful. I just had my little list and off I went. I always do my Christmas shopping Christmas Eve. Yes. So I'm just looking at it. I'm satisfied with it. So I'm going to go in. Woohoo! And we are going to color. Get those Prisma pencils out. I was thinking of doing it with the Gamsol, but I didn't have time. I mean, I literally took my jacket off and sat down at my craft island and got this colored. So there's no fancy color in here. It's just two colors, you know, just to do a little bit of shading at the end. But most of it is just one. You know how soft the Prisma pencils are on craft cardstock. It's absolutely beautiful. And you're going to get a tutorial that's only 16 minutes long. Woohoo! Go right over your pencil work. If you do a sketch, go right over it because we're going to darken up that with a black Prisma pencil. So there's no worries. You don't have to worry about erasing it while you're coloring it. Just keep going. And I had my, I'm going to leave this time, I keep forgetting, but it's a Boss Stitch pencil sharpener, an electric one that stops when it comes to a perfect point. And yeah, so if you see me just kind of hesitate, that's what I'm doing there. I am just going back and making sure that it's a little pointy. I didn't worry about it here, and I'll tell you why. The pencil lead was a little shaky, and I wanted to make sure I used all that lead right up to the, you know, to the end before I sharpened it, even if it fell off. I wasn't going to waste anything. And here you go, just really press on that. It works really nice on the glass when you're doing this. And we're just going to continue. I'm going to really speed it up next just to get it finished for you. 13 minutes and 22 seconds. This has got to be a record card for me. And it's an A2 card. Yes, no dimension on it whatsoever. Yeah. Start laughing, everybody. Carol did an A2 card, and I did it under a half an hour. And then I just left it for her to pick up at the house while I went out. Yeah, I had to add a card base underneath because I had something on the glass mat. It looked like a little bit of glue because, you know, and look at the white Prisma pencil. Is that white or what? It's gorgeous. Yeah. And don't put your black outline until you get all your coloring in. you know. Then you can go in and any little areas that you kind of miss, you can, yellow eyes, and just, I'm pressing really hard. You know, I'm able to get that real good, you know, like I like to do with everything, just give it some pressure, and pressure coloring, that's what I'm going to call this. And Prisma pencils are the ultimate for this. And like I said, I went underneath the little white ruffles with a darker red, kind of like a burgundy, just to make it look like it had some shading. And now I'm going to go over it in fast motion, and we are going to do all of the black areas, you know, the eyelashes here and the eyes. Kind of would have been cute if I had thought of it, I would have put googly eyes, the tiny little mini googly eyes, but you know, I didn't have time. But I was really happy that this is exactly what she wanted. It didn't even, on the card that she found, all it had was that saying on the front. So she was really thrilled to be able to get a picture of her as a Grinch. I said, how do you like your nice green skirt there, Kate? Yeah. Oh, here's the dark. Yes, I did put it in there. I'm shading it and I'm putting a little bit of mint. I lightened up the areas there. And there you have it, my friends. I stamp it with Created Especially for You by Carol Held. I grabbed the matching envelope, slid it in, and then I realized, uh-oh, I think she wants me to put his name in calligraphy on the front. So that's what I did. And we're finished, my friends. This is unbelievable that I did a card under 15 minutes. Yes, I just thank you for your comments that you have been leaving me, and just I pray that the Lord will give you a blessed time tomorrow, and that you just enjoy your meal. I'm going to be cooking the meal tomorrow, and I'm going to be doing the, let me see, my part is the turkey, then I do a chicken because my husband has gout, he can't eat turkey. And I'll do the stuffing, and then I do the sweet potato pies, and yeah, so that's what I do. And then my daughter-in-laws, they do the rest, so I'm looking forward to a nice meal. A thank you to everybody that left me a comment wishing my family a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I just want to say the same to everybody that views this tutorial. Take care, my friends.